Yo, what's going on? It's your boy Saint Joe, SoundsAgear.com. You know what it is, man. Today we checking out Time Warp 2600 by Way Outwear. It's an emulation similar to the ARP 2600 modular synthesizer. It's supposed to have some good analog sounding circuitry and thickness and everything to get away from all the digital sounding synths. Digital isn't bad, you know, but sometimes you like to mix it up. So I'm gonna just go through some of the sounds basically, and each sound will show you pretty much how you can route the patches, and you know, you can put your own patches and stuff in there and create your own different sounds and just kind of experiment. So I'm gonna just go through a few of them, go through the interface and then go through some of the sounds. So of course you can see right here you got the number of voices that you want per note. Right now it's set to 1, but it can go all the way up to 8 voices. There's your MIDI, your level, your CPU. Here's your patch manager if you want to go in there and look at your different patches and stuff like that. Or you can, there's where you can save, or you can go like, you know, just browse your patches this way. This shows you what kind of instrument you're in, and then this is the presets in that instrument category. And this is just your default. So here's your different instrument banks. As you can see, so you can go through all the different banks, or you can just go through the default. So it comes with a lot of different sounds. But anyway, let's go through the default. So here's just a little bass. So as you can see, it's got a pretty thick sound to it. Of course, you can use the mod wheel to mess with the. You see my frequency moving. And also, if you notice when I'm playing a key, you see some of the circuits moving around. Let's look at different. Here's a Moog bass. Where's that? This one's pretty cool, heavy dub. So it's a pretty deep, thick sound to it. Of course, if you want to mess, you know, the best way I think to mess around is just to get in there and see what happens when you start pulling patches all over the place. And sometimes if you can't, in real life patch something somewhere, then it won't let you do it here. Well, I mean, of course you could patch it wherever you want, but sometimes you'll get a specific type of feedback. So you just mess around. If you want to take that off, you just do it like that. Another one I like was the fat bass. That's just messing with the frequency. Listen, if I hold the key down, you can hear the, you know, sort of an analog on how it changes over time. So it's kind of, it's got that random analog sound. Let's check out some of the leads. And you can, like I said, this is a, just going through the presets is a good way to kind of get an idea of how things, how modular synthesis works, because they already got the patches in there. So you can kind of study those and see what's doing what in the presets. So when you want to make your own, you kind of have an idea. Let's see, let's check out this one here. Mess with whatever. So you never know what you're gonna get. So it can get pretty funky, man, you know. Like Like I said, it has a nice different sound compared to a lot of other synthesizers I've messed with. I like the randomness of it because you get that random, you know, if you hold a key down, you can kind of hear it moving and pulsating, and I like that. And so just messing with the sliders, man, you can come up with totally different sounds. It encourages you to experiment. So I really like that. Let's check out. Got some arpeggios. So you can't be mad at nothing like that. And you can see how all the patching is going, so you can study it. Kind of make up your own some rhythms. We're gonna get into some kind of synthy rhythms going on. You got some percussion. Let's see what else we got in here. A little bell. So as you can see, just messing with the sliders, you can come up with some brand new sounds, man, which is, it's always good where a synth allows you to get in easily and make stuff. Pads, you gotta have good pads. I mean, I'm definitely not gonna be able to go through all these patches. This one doesn't even have any patches going on. Just mess with some of the stuff and see what happens. See if we can patch something to somewhere. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just messing around, of course. That's how you do it. The more you mess around, the more you learn. Well, you know, something like that. Let's see what kind of sound effects we got going on. Some of that old Twilight Zone stuff right there. You see how as I hold it, if you watch up there, you see how my frequency is changing just by holding down the key, which is, you know, due to my various, how the patches are going. And, you know, it just operates like an analog circuit, you know, would operate. What's this? Guitar effects, so I guess. This is if you're going to put your, hook your guitar into it and use it as an effects. But as you can see, I got a lot more, you know, plugins here. A lot more presets. I mean, we could be here all day just going through the presets. So, yeah, man, Time Warp. 2600, I really like it. I like the sound of it, I like the texture, I like the randomness of it. I like that it's easy to patch and It gives you a different sound than some of the digital synths that are out there. So go check it out. Way Out Where. I think you can actually get it from SonicVoxMI.com as well. So it's your boy St. Joe, SoundsAgain.com.